Alicia Cheney, and we're here with Katherine Randolph, one of the new actresses in Centurion AD, and we're going to talk to her about the upcoming movie. So, Katherine, I'm excited to know more about this. What was your role in the movie?
I play Kim Harris in the movie, and she is a nurse who has lost her husband a couple of years ago, and she's very pragmatic, very down to earth, and I would definitely call her an ordinary woman in extraordinary circumstances.
Now, why would you say extraordinary circumstances? What makes her circumstances so out of the normal?
Well, her life is going along pretty normally until we reach the beginning of the movie, at which point, without giving away too much,
don't want to do that.
She meets a man who may be an angel after being hit by a car. Her life is saved by this man, and she and the character of Basil, who is right there, are trying to find him and find out who he is and what his story is. And so that's the thing that changes her life immediately, is meeting Archer.
And what initially, I guess, attracted you to the role? Was it the script that you read? What lured you to the role that you're playing in this movie?
A couple things. First of all, the character of Kim is, she, like I said, she's a lot like me, but in extraordinary circumstances. So to have the opportunity to play a character that you feel a connection with, going through something that you probably won't get to go through in your own life, that's always really fun for me. I like doing strong women characters. That's really...
So this gave you an outlet to project that.
Right, absolutely. And I love, like, the whole, like, angels and demons, and done as... I mean, we've seen action movies with vampires and werewolves and, you know, all kinds of other magical creatures. And I think that angels and demons haven't been done as much as... You know, well, lately vampires have been. So I think that it's that melding of what audiences like to see with fantasy and special effects and that kind of thing, and then also melding it with the faith-based part of the script, so that there's more to it than it just being an action thriller.
So how did the process start as far as going in for the audition? What did you have to do, or what did you demonstrate that maybe stood out?
When you get an audition, there are sides attached, which means that there are scenes from the movie, and you prepare those scenes and you go in and you read. And I met with Brian, the director, and I read with him and another one of the guys who's in the movie who had already been cast. And we practiced the scenes a couple of times, and they shot it on camera and gave me direction. And I think from the very start, it was definitely a symbiotic relationship. Like, we definitely were... You know, I was vibing with the other guys.
That's a good thing.
You know, from the very beginning. So I think that made it easy.
Easy. I think that's great when you have that natural on camera, you know, even off camera sort of chemistry, because then what you see on camera comes across even so, you know, much more real, basically. Mm-hmm. So I think that's really great. Now, you mentioned working with Brian. He's the director on this movie. What was the set atmosphere and what was it like working with him?
The set atmosphere was very familial. That would definitely be the word that I would use to describe it the most. Brian always was open to our ideas, which is wonderful, but at the same time, he knew what he wanted. So he knew where he was going with things, but he was also open to ideas that would maybe take it to the next level. So that's always really great as an actor when you have a director who is open to other people's ideas, because film is a collaborative art, and I always feel like the more people that are collaborating, the better that it gets. But at the same time, if someone's too open, then it can become scattered. So it's good that he knew where he was going, but he was also open to other people's ideas. And like I said, it was definitely a family atmosphere. You know, anybody that wasn't in the shot was pitching in and helping with other things. And I always enjoy that atmosphere on set when you really get to have that collaboration with everyone.
Well, that's a great thing about a character. You get a chance to project things that aren't necessarily who you are, kind of take on different roles, but then you get a chance to go home and be yourself, Katherine.
Yes, and that's one of the things that was nice about playing Kim, is that I was getting to play someone who I identify with.
Okay.
A lot of the times, you know, I'm playing a witch or, you know, a military operative or, you know, something that is much further beyond my mm-hmm. realm of experience, and characters that are, you know, on the run or killing people or, you know, these things that I don't have experience with in mm-hmm. my life. And it was really nice to play a character who was very real to me and whose personality was a lot like my personality, who's down to earth. And it made it very easy for me in the scenes that I was doing to relate on a very human level.
Now, you mentioned she loses her husband, so I'm kind of curious. Now, mm-hmm. did you have to pull some real emotional scenes in order to project that? Does her husband, I don't know if that's given away too much, die during the movie? Or, you know, what did you pull on to be able to maybe really project those real emotional roles?
He actually died before the movie started. But that does come back into play with part of the movie, but I won't give anything away by saying more than that. But, you know, definitely with the emotion of that, one of the things that made pulling on that sadness easy for me is one of the nights that we were shooting, it was a very emotional scene in a church. Mm-hmm. And my grandmother, who's very close to me, passed that day. And I, early the next morning, had to fly back to Mississippi for her funeral. So having that close for me, I mean, it was definitely difficult for me to shoot that night, but at the same time, I was really emotionally available.
Yeah.
So that was definitely something that I pulled on, you mm-hmm. know, for the emotional accuracy of it.
Wow. And so often, so many times when people watch a movie, they don't know maybe the behind the scenes, you know, story that goes with it, that you had lost your grandmother right at a pivotal point as you're shooting some of these roles. So it's good in the extent how you mentioned that you were able to draw on that, but obviously you did suffer a loss. So you mm-hmm. did have a place of being able to project the emotion that goes along with someone who is grieving, you know, because mm-hmm. a lot of people, they'll look and want to know, is that real? Is it genuine? So it's good that you were able to probably, you know, accurately portray that. So, wow. Well, wonderful talking with you. Anything else, I guess, that you would think viewers or the audience, moviegoers, should know or need to know about going to see this? Are you excited to see it?
I'm very excited to see it myself. And just from the atmosphere when we were shooting and from reading the script, I really think it's going to be a really fun movie. And a movie that you can also take a little bit more away from, you know, than just having had a good time. I think it'll make you, you know, ask yourself some questions that are always good to ask yourself. So I'm definitely excited to see it.
Well, good.
I'm excited for other people to see it.
That's always good. So very good. It's great when you can be so, you know, comfortable and so proud of the work that you've done. So I'm excited now that you've kind of given me a little snippet of it. So great talking to you, Katherine.
Well.
And I look forward to seeing it.
Thank you.
Thank you. We'll be back with more behind the scenes interviews with some of the cast from Centurion AD.